What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to download and set up BlueStacks 5 on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. First of all, to download BlueStacks, navigate to BlueStacks.com. From here, select to download the BlueStacks 5 installer for Windows. When looking to use the emulator on a Windows 11 PC, then select See All Versions. You can then proceed to download the optimized for Windows 11 64-bit installer. The download will only take a second to complete, and you can then proceed to double-click the installer file. Allow BlueStacks to make changes to your PC if you have admin permissions, and the installer will proceed to download and install the Android emulator to your system. This can take anywhere from a minute to half an hour, depending on your download and write speeds. You may have to disable your antivirus while installing BlueStacks if you encounter any installation issues. You also need at least 2 GB of free storage space on the drive you select to install BlueStacks. When the installation is complete, BlueStacks will open up automatically. You can proceed to click on Play Store and log in with your Google account, preferably the same account that you have used with previous Android devices. This will allow you to get access to past purchases and downloads. When this is done, proceed to install games or other apps. In order to get the most out of the BlueStacks emulator, I highly suggest that you apply a few settings to improve your emulator performance. Click on the gear icon on the bottom left of the BlueStacks window. In the performance section of your settings, make sure to increase the CPU allocation to all available cores from your processor. In a lot of cases, this will be 4 or 8 cores. Below, allocate enough memory or RAM for the application to utilize. If you plan on playing games on BlueStacks, then 2 GB would be great if you only have around 4 GB of available memory on your PC. If you have 8 or 16 GB, then allocate 4 GB for BlueStacks to use while it's running. You can also use a custom value, for example when using a PC with only 2 GB of available RAM. Then you can set this to 1600 MB, for example. In case you're unsure about how much RAM you can allocate for BlueStacks to use, then open up your Task Manager. Here, in the Performance tab, make sure that you're in the Memory section to see how much RAM you're currently using and how much you might have available. Don't be discouraged when you see that over half of your memory is being used while Windows is in idle. This is normal, as some of the Windows features are stored in your memory at all times, but can be reduced when it's needed by an application such as BlueStacks. In my case, I have access to 16 GB of physical memory, 6 of which I can easily allocate to BlueStacks, as I don't use other applications while BlueStacks is running. Back in your BlueStacks settings, set your performance mode option to low memory or balanced mode. This will depend on your PC's specifications. Higher-end PCs should use balanced mode. It will optimize your memory or RAM usage as well as your performance. The low memory mode will conserve more memory usage by cutting out some visual effects, for example. If you wish to use a custom frame rate or FPS above 60, then toggle the Enable High Frame Rate option on. It will allow you to set your max frame rate to 240, but this is in most cases not needed. I like to set this to 144, but users struggling to get 60 FPS should cap their FPS to a value such as 45 or 30, to make sure that at least these frames are not missing and that the game is not lagging. I prefer to disable the VSync option and enable the Display FPS during gameplay option to troubleshoot any potential performance issues. After saving your changes, you might be asked to restart the BlueStacks emulator, which will only take a couple of seconds to do. In the Display section of your BlueStacks settings, use a resolution which is not too high, such as 1280x720. This is, in a lot of cases, still a good resolution for mobile games, especially in landscape mode. In your graphics settings, set your graphics engine mode option to performance. You can leave the other settings to their default values, and make sure that the GPU in use option is enabled, in order to use your graphics processor to help run the emulator on your PC. After applying your settings changes, there are a few more steps you should consider to improve your gaming performance on BlueStacks. While BlueStacks is running, open up your task manager. Here, right-click the BlueStacks process and select to go to details. In the details section of your task manager, the hdplayer.exe process should be highlighted. Go ahead and right-click this process and set its priority to high. This will allow your PC to reserve more resources to run BlueStacks compared to other applications running in the background while you're in-game. Back in the Processes section of your Task Manager, you can, in addition, prevent some resource-intensive processes from running, but make sure to only end processes from running which you know won't break your operating system, especially applications such as Google Chrome, OBS, or Adobe applications will use up most of your available memory and cause lag while using BlueStacks. Next, make sure that your graphics driver and operating system is up to date. In your Windows settings, click on Windows Update on the bottom left of this window. Here, make sure to download and install the latest update before restarting your PC. This can, in a lot of cases, fix lag and FPS drops while using BlueStacks, depending on how often you keep your system up to date. After updating your Windows OS, make sure that your graphics driver is up to date. When using an NVIDIA GPU, then I suggest using the GeForce Experience application, and AMD users can use the AMD Radeon software. You can download both applications for free in case you haven't already. In your GeForce Experience application, head over to the driver section and proceed to download and install the latest driver. This will help you run games on the BlueStacks emulator. Lastly, you should set the graphics preference for BlueStacks to high performance. In your Windows settings, navigate to System, Display, Graphics. In your graphics settings, go ahead and select to browse to add BlueStacks to this list of apps. In your File Explorer, navigate to the drive on which you installed BlueStacks, Program Files, BlueStacks, and in this folder, locate and add the HD Player application. After adding the app, click on Options and make sure to set the graphics preference to High Performance. This will make sure that your graphics card gets utilized when needed compared to other processes, which might also need your GPU to run. To further fix lag and improve your overall performance, make sure to lower your in-game settings while using the BlueStacks emulator. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.